Welcome back, everybody, here to your big point battle. It is game number two of the best of three matchup here in the quarterfinals. Team Dignitas going up against Team Liquid in the All-American Affair. Let's jump ourselves inside the game. The draft's already begun. Welcome in my co-commentator. Also, would you believe American? You are American, aren't you? Not Canadian.
No, I'm actually Chinese, but I live in America, so I'm American.
You're an American citizen, though.
Unfortunately, I'm not, but let's just say I am.
Really? So you're actually a Chinese citizen?
Yes.
Ah, interesting. Interesting. I would like to have your passport to get into China whenever I wish to. I'm being joined by Sneaking. He's a man who is currently not involved in any team, but was, everyone will probably know him from his days in Team Dignitas. So it's good to have you actually broadcasting this game out when we have Dignitas playing. Are we gonna go again with our same bands? Again, that clockwork being taken out. But they were beaten to the gyro this time. Fluff took out the gyro this time.
Yeah, Dignitas is very fearful of the Liquid clockwork. I mean, they have great success with it recently as well. I mean, I think they're undefeated or something. Or near undefeated, if not undefeated, with the clockwork.
I want to say that Liquid was second. Liquid was second to do it. It was Virtus Pro, Santa. That was the first man who was bringing it back.
5 seconds remaining.
I'm not going to say it was the first person to have to play clockwork, but he was the guy to be doing it a lot of recent times. But he is like the flavor of the month, Clockwork Goblin. It's almost next to Warlock, but only for a few teams who do that. We'll see if Fog slips him through again. Going to ban out the Chaos Knight, so it looks like he wanted to bait through both the Coddle as well as the Batrider. So Fluff's got the choice now. Batrider or Coddle? I don't know about you, man, but I would always go with the Coddle.
That's what I was thinking. Since you got Coddle, I'll go Bat. See who's right here. Come on, Fluff.
Come on, Fluff. You better pick that Coddle, man. It's exactly what Team Liquid always loves to do. Damn you to hell!
Pick Sneeder.
We're both wrong. All right. But that means both Keeper of the Light as well as Batrider gets to go the way of Fogged. So we get a stable solo mid. We get a counter pusher. The downside for it all is Keeper of the Light. A Knight's here to try and focus and target if you're looking for easy kills when you got a Wisp in tow. But the funny thing is that Fogged bad out the CK and they'll still pick up the Wisp.
10 seconds remaining.
And again, these guys, they always take so much time on these first two picks. I always get surprised about it with a team that does that, because normally, I would assume, you would know exactly what you want to pick up. Like, if this happens, then I'll do this.
Dire team pick.
But they just seem to be taking their sweet-ass time. And Batrider and Nakes will be coming up, so we at least get one of our heroes. It looks like I'm going to have to wait until the very end. At least I'm still going to be right that Team Liquid will take the Keeper of the Light. Just a different order, Sneaking.
Yeah, unfortunately I'm wrong, because Batrider's on the other team already.
By the way, I'm supposed to give you a whole lot of crap from Chappie.
10 seconds remaining.
To get your mic fixed. To buy a new mic. More than $10.
More than $10? Yeah, okay. I'll have Complexity sponsor me.
That's what it's all about, man. Get those sponsorships. Complexity, aren't they their Sound Blaster?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what happened to it. It just turned out like this.
Hang on, are you actually using a Sound Blaster headset then?
Yeah, that I got received at DreamHack.
So it's actually a $10 headset. You're actually walking around with like a $100 headset.
Yes, it has great sound quality, but microphone, questionable.
It's good that he's not with any team right now. And this isn't sponsored by Sound Blaster. So Team Liquid, there's our Keeper of the Light. But that means he's already picked up both his two supports already. And we're looking at Fog with two cores. Unless we're going to see Nakes jump himself inside the jungle. And we see Dignitas just abandon the top lane, which... I've actually been seeing more and more Nakes do it. It almost feels like Nakes has been doing the same thing as what Darkseer has been doing. And that's just hiding. Also, another hero that hasn't been picked or banned.
Puck.
But they go with Puck again. Okay.
Radiant team.
No Nakes this time to combo, though.
Yeah. I'm a little curious on what hero they're going to combo the Whips with, because the CK was banned, and they typically run the CK with the Whips.
I love how this guy called Dagdia. He came up with a solution to our bet before. It's a wisp of the light.
10 seconds remaining.
That's what was picked up in the first one, man. Yeah.
I mean, they always go in pairs, pretty much, whenever we see whips and caught in the game.
Dire team ban. Well, for most of the time. Until we hit about that 10-minute mark, and then at which point Keeper of the Light just seems to sit on one lane and just farm it up and hold it solo as a support.
And then next thing you know, he has a heart and 5k life.
Or a Soul Cuirass like we saw up on Gold Black. That was so ridiculous in that game. Just like looking at him walking around. What's he got? Yeah, basic items for Keeper of the Light. And then 5 minutes later, AC.
It's very ridiculous how fast Caudle can farm. It's one of the only supports that can ever get farmed. But Gold Black gets farmed on every support.
Yeah. Just one thing I think needs to be changed around with Keeper of the Light is this Illuminant. It still takes out Siege Creeps and all this, like... I never really understood that it worked on both the Creep Wave as well as the Siege Creeps, because it just destroys any kind of mass push.
Yeah, it's great for turtling.
Yeah.
With Tinker?
Keeper of the Light, Tinker, Invoker, Crosswex. What you gonna do?
Enjoy.
Yeah, you don't enjoy Jack. We're getting out from Fogged. Fogged, is she banning out this Ven?
Yeah, they're just banning out possible heroes that go with Seek.
I don't even know about that, man. I loved it. I don't know if you saw the early days of Mouse Wars. It's when Alex first came to that lineup. It was when Sing Sing was leaving him, and they tried the combination of having Wisp as well as Rubick together, and just the two supports. And you take the support anywhere you want to go. Wherever you want to go, you just ulti him in and off you go. You're happy as Larry. And you initiate with that. And you leave the maneuverability in through, like, heroes normal builds, like Queen of Paintings with Blinks or Pucks who have orbs and Blink Daggers themselves. Such a better way of doing it, because you don't always need to tether up something amazing that's going to go around ganking like a CK or like a Sven. Just pull a PL and let him split push. All he's got to do, PL now banned out, but rightly so. Just see Wisp ulti PL to a lane, throw a couple of lands, throw a couple of hits, and then take it back again. Split push central.
Bam, you have Cancer there.
Cancer Lancer. Horrible thing, man. Horrible thing. But we're not going to see it this time around. Him and Darkseer being banned out, and Fluff going to take out. 5 seconds. A lot of single focus, as well as, again, going to take out that Undying. I say take again, it was them playing it in last game. But they'll control him and take him out. And they get Lone Druid instead, so we get TC's Bear.
Yeah. I'm not sure where the Lone Druid would be. He might be off. The Bear might be off lane or short lane.
I'm actually feeling an aggressive tri lane coming from Liquid, man. I'm feeling it. The Coddle and Wisps together.
10 seconds remaining.
Head down towards that bottom lane. Something funky is the final pickup for Liquid.
5 seconds.
Get that Alchemist up and running.
I would think that's possible, except I'm not sure what they would try lane it with, because, I mean, Dignitas banned out three of the really good heroes, Phantom Lancer, Sven, CK.
Someone in the chat's calling for Ursa.
Ursa does a lot of damage in Scream vs. Nick, but I'm not sure how he's going to work against Batrider.
Gets locked down almost instantly. Yeah. The upside, though, is the fact they do have Keeper of the Light up against Batrider. I remember when EG tried the combination, they had the Batrider and the Keeper of the Light, and you just mana drain a target, lasso, and then double four stuff. Yeah! Shout out to the guy in the chat!
Wow. Well then.
Who is the guy in the chat? It goes to... Okay, his name is not as easy. Jackalero 1.
We might see Korok playing it. I mean, Korok really favors that Ursa, so...
Can you just feel the level 1 Roshan right now?
Definitely looks like a level 1 Roshan.
I'm pretty sure Dignitas are going to check it. They don't have to check it with, like, too risky. Like, send Dangerous Prophet's treason, and you're good to go. But I wonder if Team Liquid still just won't care, because the level 1 fire for Team Dignitas really isn't anywhere near as strong as what Team Liquid has. They might just force it.
Yeah, they can definitely cam the bear tanking the Roshan and do Ursa. Two bears got this.
If two bears aren't enough, just Puck and keep with light spamming out Coddle Blast as well as like illusionary orbs. Team Dignitas never gets close to it. It should be enough. It should be more than enough. But who just fogged one? Because right now we need a support hero that probably has a level 1 fighting potential.
I'm not sure. I think it might be a mid solo he's looking for here, because I think the Nakes will go, the Leshard will move the Nakes, and then Prophet is jungle or offlane with the, like, similar to Batrider.
Lina's the it's final one.
So it's going to be a Furion solo mid, possibly?
I still think we're going to see Batrider in the middle lane. The fact that Bulba takes up the puck.
Yeah, like I said, Korok really likes his Ursa. Yep. So with Fog's going to play the Batrider middle.
Yeah, that's going to be a lot easier for Fogged. That's if Ursa ends up in the mid. We can see Bulba go solo mid. It was his old role before he started going off laners all the time.
I mean, I played Whips Ursa the other day, and it's a very strong combo. If you let the Ursa snowball, especially on Dire side, you're never going to see Roshan. It's always going to be too light there. It's going to be very annoying for the Team Dignitas if they lose the early game here.
Just mark that timing. It's like before you even start, just type in like 0-0 time, time of Roshan dying, and then 20 minutes, 40 minutes.
Prepare for battle.
Take no time whatsoever. Alright, so how are we now going to look? So we'll have Fluff and stuff. You'll be support. They're not making a quick run for Roshan. And surprisingly, too, that Dignitas aren't even checking it.
I think they're both pretty confident that the other person will probably check, or knowing that Dignitas will check, there's no point doing it, or it's a little bit risky, just play safe.
Well, we can at least see our lanes, man. So we TC up on the top lane, taking up the role as lone druid. Bulba will be the solo mid, and it's the Grocer tri lane with something funky. It's the Ursa combining up with Wisp as well as Fluff, and then through the Dignitas lineup, we don't know where exact lanes just yet.
30 seconds.
But we'll find out in a moment. We'll see if we're going to see another aggressive tri lane with the Nakes in it. It does look like Aoi's going to hang around up here, and be sitting around with Way2. Tide's right behind him. So that'll be our top lane. They'll have to really be using that open wound to set up for both those stuns. And then towards the middle lane, Fogged. Universe is heading down towards the bottom lane, but he might have to stay in the jungle for a very long time. He's trying to scout out with his troops to see what's going on down here. But you see Liquid's almost intention to go, like, gank on the bottom lane. That one dire ward behind the tower. They want to know when someone's come in.
Invisibility.
And TC's not feeling comfortable all up here. It's like everything is blind. They just threw down that dire ward as well, so I didn't realize the invis room was taken by Latrac. He's looking in for Bulba on the mid lane. No, he'll move out. He finds TC instead.
Might be a kill here if Lina catches up, because TC is taking a lot of damage from these creeps right now.
Yeah, Munt is on the tango, but he got revealed quickly. Slight strike array. TC, too much damage. That bear's got to get on the back of Tides. He's going to try and deny himself for the jungle creeps. He's going to be successful.
Whoa! Big plays by TC, denying the first blood.
So support story tape for nothing at the end of the day. He will be without a bear for 26 seconds, but he'll just pull. While Korok has more fun on the bottom lane, tethering in. They are searching. They are so searching for Universe, and they found him. He's in the tree line, trying to go down there into Demon Spot, and Universe blocked in, and that's going to be our first blood. One more paw swipe by Korok. Not actually going to be it. It's Fluff who gets the attack. The first blood is still spilt in that bottom lane in favor of Team Liquid.
Yep.
TC gets to go next level. Not only does he save the first blood from going against him, but he's also able to make sure it goes towards that bottom lane.
yeah, Nature's Prophet is just going to jump now. That's clearly he can't play lane bottom.
Yeah. Either that or they switch their lanes up. But Nate's having such a good time up here on the top lane. Like, he's already 13 for nil. But then again, at the same time, they'd have to realize that if they do that, and they keep going on the top lane, they're going to be the ones to lose a tower first. And it's going to be Liquid to take that tier 1 tower in the bottom lane. And TC just trying to farm up inside the jungle. The two supports have rotated back over again.
I'm not sure if this is the correct decision by Dignitas, because having a good early start in Ursa is definitely better than having it on Nate's. Because I think if Dignitas rotates bottom and tri-lanes versus their tri-lane, I think they would definitely have a
big man. Look at the chain stun off on TC. He's not close enough to the Tornado creeps to deny himself off, and Prophet's going to TP in too. Not enough damage. 19 HP. Bulber also coming back in to help, and TC, you got to be careful, man. Radiance bottom tower is Sav under gets attack. Triggered off, and so he doesn't get the full duration of it. Tower is under attack. But doesn't die again. As I was talking about the tier 1 tower in the bottom lane, they're just mopping up the creep wave, and then back onto the tower.
TC, really good plays by TC there, not dying. I mean, he's pulling all three supports, Nature's Prophet. I mean, they're both level 1, and Nature's Prophet is almost level 3. They're very under-level compared to the dire supports.
Mm-hmm. Man, if you can, try and keep your mic as close to your mouth as possible. Sounds like you're walking away from it. Oh, there's Kurok now taking the last hit in the bottom lane. So, phase boost for him if he wants it. Chase hard, chase fast. And Dignitas still in no position to push out this top lane because they never got that kill on the top. So we haven't seen Way Too Sexy even get 1 point up in Edict, so we cannot force this tower out. And how's our middle lane looking? Bulber at 13 for 4 up against 17 for 2 Fogged. I'd say it's pretty even apart from the fact that Bulber's pretty low on life. Pretty low on the levels in comparison to Fogged.
It's pretty hilarious. Liquid is stacking the Radiant jungle and just Fluff is just gonna farm it here with whiffs.
It's the power of Keeper of the Light. Make the most of whatever jungle you can get access to. Once we finally see that top tower go down now that Lashrak gets a point up in Edict. So there's still one tower for one tower. The difference is gonna be the timing of it all. Like, what do we got it for Wisp? Like, Wisp is level 3 in a bit. And the longer they stay down here, yeah, they got that secondary stack again.
It's gonna be the supports by Liquid are just having so much more farm and levels, and I think that's gonna play a critical role in this game.
But you wonder how long it can remain. Like, Universe is now inside his own jungle in the safe camps. It's the good thing that Dignitas the Radiant side with this kind of play, because over on the Dire side, this wouldn't be possible. You don't have the safety of being next to your mid lane. And the Dire jungle is just so much more exposed. But that's why you become a lone druid. And if he keeps finding his levels here. Like, you look at his levels in comparison to the other off lane. Like, Nature's Prophet was meant to be the off laner, and he's at level 3 3/4. And then you go through TC, who with this last Sata, should hit 3.5. Yeah, 3.5 for him. So there's very little difference between the two of them. 12 for nil up against 15 for 1. So they're both being shot down as badly as each other.
Korok's currently sitting on 2,000 gold. I mean, he might go for a quick Vlad's and then just solo Roshan altogether. I'm not sure what he wants to do here.
I'll go crazy and go Blink Dagger. It is Korok we're talking about, man.
Indeed, we are. Yeah, forgot to include that factor.
Yes. It's like whenever you see Havorst, it's like, yeah, this guy is going to dive. It doesn't matter if it's not logical to do so. He's going to dive it. It's just what happens. But he's now got the 2200, so we'll see if I'm right. And we'll see the Blink Dagger walking over to the side shop. He's not doing it. He's going back into lane. Man, can he just not decide? Maybe that's it. He's just waiting to see what's the best item to get.
Perhaps, but on Dignitas, AUI 2000 just picked up the Midas.
Nice to have up already. But he still needs to find, like... I always worry about Midas's going up on Nakes. Especially when you have a hero like a Wisp who's still finding levels. They're going to try and gank up in the mid.
Yep.
Coddle Blast being pretty hard here on Fogged if he was in the right position, but he's not. Puck Goldie just trying to hold him there, but he's just basically dancing around inside the Puck Goldie. And then the Flame Break pushes him away. Quick blast from Coddle, but Wisp takes the kill. And with that, he hits level 5.25. Waiting for that level 6 from him.
That was a great gank by Liquid.
It's and Blink.
They're just going to Roshan.
They're going to Roshan
off of this.
It's actually a Blink on Korok. I love it, man. I love it.
And I guess he doesn't need the Blats after all. He's getting the mana from Fluff.
Mm-hmm. And Mike can keep him up if things go horribly, horribly wrong.
But like I said, if Dignitas loses his early game, it's going to be hell for them. They're never going to see light of day with this Roshan.
Well, Fog was looking for an opening here. It's a good thing for him, the Bulbasaur still has ulti on cooldown. But Korok's on the hunt. 2 points up in the Earth Shock. Kind of just shows you too what he's looking to combine.
Take a look at bottom. I think Universe backs off. I think Korok's is going to get Soul Kid there.
Yeah. But with a 35% move slow, I like how too he's just spread himself out. Like the amount of times you see Ursas, and they have those 4 points up in the Fury Swipes. And maybe they'll get 1 point up in Earthshock. Everything else just goes into Overpower. Overpower.
The slow is insanely good considering its mana cost. It's a very good spell and cooldown. It's only 6 seconds. Absurdly low.
What else we got flying in? There's the Urn for Mike. And he's level 6 now. So Mike is level 6. Looks like he's still building up the Tranquil. Okay, he's got to use something here. There we go. Now he can pick up the Urn. But Tether and Ulti. Who do they go on? They need somebody to be in the wrong position. Look at Korok. He's already prepared. We're heading middle lane. Looking for Fogged. Beat him down. And they get him. Probably wasn't really needed though. Bolt did most of the work on that.
Yeah, I mean, this is just slowing down Fogged's Blink very much. It's the second time he died at 2,000. He just keep delaying his Blink. It's great plays by Liquid. I'm not sure if they noticed, but it's probably planned.
Probably next level. That's what Team Liquid's meant to be, man. Next level.
We see Korok soloing a hero right middle.
Really? Question if you'll get out of this one safely.
I think you'll kill. No, he doesn't want to turn around. I think he would have killed her lifesteal if he turned around.
Aegis. Damn, that music is just so weird! I want to turn it off. It was like when they gave like the buyback music when they first inserted it into the game.
Yeah. I mean, I don't really understand the point of having the Aegis music. It's just really telling your opponent, oh, I'm coming up, you should really run.
It's just meant to be epic. Duh, duh, duh.
I think what Valve should do is include a buyback music for change it, because right now it's the same buyback music for your teammates and your enemy, so it's sometimes confusing. Like when your teammate buy out, you think the enemy bought out. So I think they should do something unique.
There is that wonderful thing where it does little gold coins above the hero names. That's for me.
Well, sometimes when you're in a dire situation, you just hear the sound. You're like, oh, someone bought out, run.
Oh, we're gonna ulti again by Mike and Korok. Top lane! Universe is the man! Blink! And didn't even need to clap. He saved his mana on that one. But they're gonna come back towards mid lane in a moment. You already see Dignitas. They're half prepared for this. And now they come back. Mike slowed up. Get in there, Korok! He's gonna start up on Aoi. Aoi forced to infest to live through this. And Korok fighting within the middle of the Firefly. But it still doesn't stop him from killing off the Latrak. Ty's trying to chase him, gonna miss the stun. But they've still got enough damage to kill him off, ending the dominating spree, giving the cash over to Lina. Arcane Boots for her.
Korok sitting on 2.5k gold again. What do you think he's gonna get this time, Toby?
I'm gonna go with Basher. I'm going everything which isn't standard.
Yeah, I don't want to say what he's gonna get, because I'm gonna be wrong.
Just go straight into a Zul'Kuras. See Mjolnir come out in him. What the hell? Radiant's middle tower. He buys Wand. But still 2.1, like, yeah, he's still got another Blink Dagger there. Mithril Hammer.
Yeah, probably BKB coming out for him.
Yeah. It would be the wisest thing, considering just how much control is there from Dignitas. It's only the Batrider who's going to go through that BKB anyway. Nature's Prophet, of course, can sprout him. But you got to be bloody good as a Nature's Prophet to do that.
Yeah, and I think what they're going to do is just straight up have the Puck ulti and silence the Batrider and just blow the Batrider up first with the Ursa. And then everything else is dealable with the BKB on.
Where are we moving?
TPing mid.
Yep. Jump it all in. Try and kill off that Latrak again. Kurok can't get close enough. Slows down Aoi for a moment, and Puck, too much damage to be taken. 5 seconds before Mike will be able to get himself back out. Maybe not. He just tethers through Fogged, and he's going to pull Kurok out with him. Where's the rest of our engagement gone? Where the hell do they go? Back towards the base. And in comes Kurok. Blink, attack, Fog, destroyed. Kurok all over like a hot rash. And he wants to go in deeper. Mike as well as Kurok. Kurok, he's got that Blink off cooldown in 1 second time, but the trees are stalking him. So he just eats up the trees instead. And now they'll take the tier 1 tower and mid in the back of TC.
Radiant structures are fortified.
That bear's already doing good damage. TC, the guy who had a hard time up on top lane, walking around with Hand of Myers and Phase Boots up on his bear. And Tranquil Boots coming his way. That's Universe. His Hand of Myers is at least done now too. But he's just so far behind on the farm level. 59 for 2 ain't too shabby. But for 13 minutes in, I suppose 13 minutes in for a Hand of Myers as well as Ring Vasilis ain't too bad.
Korok's going in middle again. Looks like he's gonna get tight to time here.
I'm
done. They don't even need a Wiz Baldi, but it's back off cooldown. They just saw the stack there. It's a triple stack of Ancients. And then they give an Invis rune to Korok.
Invisibility. Let's see who's gonna die here.
Tether breaks off, and now he is the man he finds first. But the better one he finds is Latrak. He's gonna be careful. Fogged is also here. There's the tether, and instantly Fogged. He's like, what the hell is that? Stunned up, down to half life. And Prophet's TPing in for this one. He's looking for the spread up on the high ground. He finds Mike. The tether is out. Kurok wants to blink back in again, but the Prophet ultimate slowed him down. Now Bulba. Throwing down his own ultimate, and Wisp buys back to ulti himself in. Gives them that. Well, it's a mech charge coming their way. That's a lot of heal going the way of both Kurok as well as Mike. He's going to sever the tether, or else Kurok, maybe he'll just blink himself further in. That's one way to do it. Beat on Universe, and Universe locks him in a tree line. Batrider very, very low on life. But I think Tide's going to be lower in a moment. Blink, 1 second off cooldown. They're just diving inside the base, and there's Tide. It's like, wait, there's a chicken here as well as Fogged. Kurok dives down a little bit deeper, and the bear just chases him in the side. Double kill, even when there's tier 2 towers up, they don't care. They go in, and we get a 15-minute GG again. Team Liquid having fun with bears. Wow.
Great game from Liquid. I'm not sure what else to say.
Man, I'm looking forward to seeing Liquid play tomorrow. Of course, they'll be playing up against either Fnatic or 3D Max. Checking out the results for that so far. They're actually into game number 2 and Fnatic's already taken game number 1. So we'll see. Well done, Sneaking. Shout out to Complexity, yeah. May they sponsor him a new headset. Even though he's not part of their team. There you go.
Well, I do know Chappie very well. Perhaps, maybe, hook me up.
That might actually be the end of our night as far as live streams go, guys. Make sure you check out JD_Epi on Twitch TV. You'll find his link over on JD. I believe he's actually covering Mousesports versus Roxkiss. I'm just checking for it.
It's a Dota 1 team, because, I mean, they perform very well, and I've never heard of
them. So, Roxkiss.
Yeah.
Roxkiss, you should really know, man. It's Seedoy, Selenia. It's the old Z Nation.
Oh, okay. Makes sense.
Yeah, with a little bit of a change. Yeah. Just stay tuned, guys. I'll find out what games are still going. We're only meant to cast two mage games this evening. I don't want to jump onto the same game Epi's on, because you definitely check out his live stream. Just hook up Epi's live stream and you're good to go. All right, guys. So we'll be back here in a moment, maybe with another game. I want to say a big thanks to Sneaking. Thanks for joining me, man. It's been an absolute pleasure having you on the live stream.
Thank you for having me here. It was great. It was a great pleasure casting with you as well. Thank you.
Follow him over on Twitter. If you want to find it, Sneaking Dota 2, you can find him. Jing Jun Wong. Jing Jun Wu, sorry.
Yes.
Wu.
It's okay.
Wu, sorry.
Chinese names are weird. Don't worry.
Awesome. All right, guys. Stick around. I'll let you know if there's another game coming up tonight or if that is it for the evening. But remember, no matter what happens, 18 CET tomorrow night, we will have the semi-finals as well as at the grand final of the Big Boy competition. So, awesome games all time round. We'll be back, guys. We'll be back.